Hello, my sweeties, and welcome back to my channel. If you don't already know me, my name is Celise, and thank you for joining my spooky little family. In today's video, we will be talking about horror movies for hot girls and hot girls only. Let's get into the video. Okay, so I decided to do something a little fun. I actually did this on TikTok where I kind of listed a bunch of movies for hot girls only. And I figured, you know what? Let me include my YouTube spooky fam and let me go more in depth about these movies. So here we are. So for this video, we are gonna talk about 7 movies in particular. And then I will be doing a part 2 with 7 more for hot girls only. All right, let's jump right into it. At number 7, we have Jennifer's Body. A newly possessed high school cheerleader turns into a succubus who specializes in killing her male classmates. Okay, so if you've been on my channel for a while, you know, I absolutely live and breathe Jennifer's Body. Love it. One of my favorite movies for, I don't know, over a decade now. Honestly, this movie is iconic, so there's really not much for me to say because I'm sure you've all seen it. But if you have not, you need to. You need to. This is strictly a hot girls only movie, okay? We have incredible performances from Megan Fox and Amanda Seyfried. They are so good together. They just have so much chemistry. Honestly, the entire cast of this movie is very good. There's a lot of really funny jokes in this movie that still hit. And Megan Fox's delivery is just so good. She is the ultimate bad bitch. We love to see it. Also, I do want to point out that when I had first seen this movie in theater, I was pretty young. And guys, I went to go see this with my dad, and like, I was feeling things that I didn't even know existed. But really, this film is especially for the girls. Now at number 6, oh shit! I forgot to say who it's directed by, so I'm gonna say it again. Now at number 6, we have The Love Witch, directed by Anna Biller. A modern day witch uses spells and magic to get men to fall in love with her, with deadly consequences. So everything about The Love Witch is an absolute vibe. If you are a spooky bad bitch, this is the movie for you. If you absolutely love witches and the brujeria, this is for you. If you yourself are a super hot witch, this is also for you. But on a serious note, I was actually pleasantly surprised with The Love Witch. I think that the storytelling is really well done. The movie looks absolutely gorgeous. Every time I watch this movie, I am obsessed with how good it looks and how it really looks like an old school movie. Anna Biller knocks it out of the park with her direction and just everything. Our leading actress is so good, not to mention her makeup is iconic. And honestly, there are moments in this where I was watching and I kind of related to her. I was like, girl, I feel that. I would do the same thing. And you know what? That is what I want all of you beautiful ladies to experience as well. This film is definitely one to not sleep on. It is absolutely fire. Speaking of the brujeria, which if you do not speak Spanish, that means witchcraft, we are at our number 5 spot, and that is The Craft, directed by Andrew Fleming. A newcomer to a Catholic prep high school falls in with a trio of outcast teenage girls who practice witchcraft, and they all soon conjure up various spells and curses against those who anger them. So The Craft is very much like Jennifer's Body. It is a classic. A classic. I am sure all of you that watch my channel have seen The Craft because this is one of those movies that it came out and it kind of shaped a lot of spooky bad bitches. So I just assume that you guys already love this one. But if you have not seen it, we have some iconic actresses in this cast, like Neve Campbell and Fairuza Balk. We also have a babyface Skeet Ulrich, which is really cute to see. There's a lot of really fun performances in this movie, specifically from Fairuza Balk. She absolutely steals the show. Obviously, everybody is great, but I mean, this is like her moment and she shines. Not to mention, we have this really cool 90s grunge aesthetic going on in this movie, and I really love it. Not only is it nostalgic, but the looks still hold up. They are absolutely slaying throughout the entire thing. This yet again is one of the movies that shaped me into the spooky bad bitch that I am today. Now at number 4, we have Revenge, directed by Coralie Fargo. Jen is enjoying a romantic getaway with her wealthy boyfriend until his two sleazy friends arrive from an unannounced hunting trip. As tension mounts in the house, the situation abruptly and viciously intensifies, culminating in a shocking act that leaves Jen brutalized and left for dead. Unfortunately for her assailants, she survives and soon begins a relentless quest for bloody revenge. Okay, so this film stars the incredible Matilda Lutz. And if you have not seen this movie, you absolutely need to. It is on Shudder right now if you have not gotten to see it yet. This is definitely one of those movies that I did not think I would like, knowing that it is about, but seeing that it was directed by a woman, I gave it a shot. And boy, was I not disappointed. This is 110% a way to tell a story of something tragic that has happened to a woman without showing a very aggressive, graphic scene. So I have to give credit where credit is due. Not to mention, Matilda Lutz does an incredible job. She is the shining star of this entire film. She carries it on her fucking back. Not only that, we get to see her with a shotgun and just being a bad bitch the entire time with these super cute pink star earrings, which I actually have a pair that looks just like that. So, love it. I also want to point out that this film looks beautiful. It has a lot of really bright colors and it's just really nice on the eyes. Also, I do want to point out that our leading man does a great job at playing this disgusting human being. So, 10 out of 10 there. Now at number 3, we have Audition, directed by Takashi Miike. A widower takes an offer to screen girls at a special audition arranged for him by a friend to find him a new wife. The one he fancies is not who she appears to be after all. This is by far my favorite thing Takashi Miike has ever done. And I am a big fan of Takashi Miike. He has done a lot of great films like Ichi the Killer and so many others that are iconic and still good to this day. But this one by far has to be my favorite. I feel like this film is in itself a masterpiece. The acting is so good, especially from our leading woman. She does a great job at being eerie and creepy and just unpredictable. I also think that this movie looks really cool too. I love the cinematography and I also just love the overall direction. This is one of those movies that is more on the disturbing side. So if you're someone that kind of has a weak stomach, maybe this one isn't for you, but I feel like it is so good that you should try to give it a chance. Also, the entire last act of this movie is awesome. Next at number 2, we have Hard Candy, directed by David Slade. Haley is a smart, charming teenage girl. Jeff's a handsome, smooth fashion photographer. An internet chat, a coffee shop meetup, and an impromptu fashion shoot back at Jeff's place, and Jeff thinks it's his lucky night. Well, he is certainly in for a surprise. This film stars Patrick Wilson and Elliot Page, and oh my god, They are electric on the screen together. This is one of those movies that I watched at a young age, and I was not really ready for what was to come. This is definitely, again, more alongside of Disturbing. So again, if you are easily squeamish, this might not be for you, but I feel like it is definitely worth it. The story they are telling is not only interesting, but it is scary because it is so real and this happens so much to young girls on the internet. So really like the story that they're telling here. Not to mention, I do like how the movie looks, especially the cinematography. I think it looks really pretty. And again, this is just one of those bad bitch movies. Like, this is one of the ultimate movies for hot girls. But really, this movie is definitely one of those that you watch, and once it comes to an end, you're like, damn right. But even if you don't actually like the story, I feel like you can watch this movie and really appreciate both Patrick and Elliot's performance. Now, on a little bit of a lighter note and less disturbing for you all, we are at number one, and that is Ginger Snaps, directed by Jon Fawcett. Two death-obsessed sisters, outcasts in their suburban neighborhood, must deal with the tragic consequences when one of them is bitten by a deadly werewolf. This film stars Catherine Isabel and Emily Perkins. And again, this is one of those movies that is an absolute classic. It's iconic. I mean, if you did not see this when you were a young girl, I don't know, you better get on it. You better watch it now. But really, we do have a really great performance from both of these women. Not only that, but the story is interesting, and I feel like this movie accurately shows what it is like to be a teenage girl. I think that really has to come with the fact that this was written by a woman, and she did a great job. There is a moment in the grocery store where Ginger tells Bridget something about menstrual cramps, and it is just so relatable. And not just that, but I think incorporating a body horror that is about becoming a werewolf along with becoming a woman and transitioning into womanhood, getting your period, etc., was a brilliant idea. This is also one of those movies that the practical effects look really awesome. The entire wolf transformation is really fun to see. Catherine Isabel is a shining star in this movie, and overall, both of their looks in this movie is iconic, and anytime I watch this, I go through a whole phase where I try to dress like them, so there's that. This is another one of those movies that, like The Craft, has a very grungy aesthetic to it, so that right there just says enough. Like, we absolutely love to see that here on this channel. All right, you guys, that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, as it really helps me a lot. And be sure to click that little notification bell to be up to date every single time I upload. Also, be sure to check out all my other socials, TikTok, Twitch, my Patreon. All the links will be down in the description. Also, let me know if you've seen any of these or you're adding them to your watch list. I would love to talk about it. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.